Superbmelt vacuum induction melting furnace is developed for precious metal casting to make high quality rod and bar. According to the connection mark on the machine, connect the chiller, vacuum pump and vacuum melting furnace correctly to ensure the normal operation of the machine. Remove the copper mold from the equipment and open it up by removing the screws. And evenly apply the isolation glue to the inside of the copper mold, which can make it easier to fall off between the smelted finished product and the copper mold, which is convenient for taking out materials. After applying, install the copper mold. Put the copper mold back into the equipment. And then put the crucible into the equipment. According to different materials, choose silica or graphite crucible. Adjust the clamps to prevent the crucible from falling off. And shake down the lever, adjust the position of the copper mold, and align the crucible mouth with the copper mold, so that after the material is smelted, all the material is poured into the copper mold during the pouring process to prevent waste of material. And finally the material is put into the crucible. When no material is placed in the crucible, the power cannot be increased for heating work. Turn on the main power switch. Close the cylinder door. Open the cylinder head switch on the screen. Close the cylinder head manually. And close the cylinder head switch on the screen. When vacuumizing, the vacuum pressure gauge will drop to -0.1. Add protective gas. The protective gas flow meter can be adjusted to control the speed of adding protective gas. The vacuum pressure gauge will rise. Turn on the heating ring to rise. The equipment heating begins and can adjust the power to control the heating speed. Observe whether the material is melted on the observation mirror. After melting, turn down the power and stop heating, and the heating ring will drop. Pull the lever, pour the melted material in the crucible into the stone mold. Turn off the protective gas, open the hatch. Let the material cool. After cooling, take out the product and turn off the main power.